this is another 5-star rating pet. I recommend these snakes for your first time enthusiast. This is a corn snake. Corn snakes come from America. They're called corn snakes because of the pattern underneath the belly. Underneath the belly there, that's supposed to resemble a corn. These snakes make great pets because they're very, very docile. They don't grow too big. This is a fully grown corn snake. You know, you're not gonna have to have a massive, massive vivarium for this animal. They're very docile. They don't grow too big. Have a look at them. Absolutely incredible. They eat rats, bats, birds, frogs, toads, anything that they can overpower. It's said that they eat other snakes. I've had hundreds of corn snakes. I've never ever witnessed a corn snake eating other snakes. But in the books you read, and lots of information out there tell you that they eat other snakes. I've never witnessed that. I've never seen it at all. Absolute beautiful animal, corn snakes. Aren't they beautiful? Now, this is a zero rating reptile. Folks, this is a Burmese python. It's a granite Burmese python. It's one of the largest species of snake in the world. Does Crocodile Joe recommend Burmese pythons, reticulated pythons, African rock pythons as pets? Do they make good pets? No way. They don't make good pets, they grow too big. And once these animals start feeding, it's like turning a switch from day to night. It's like turning a light switch on. It's almost like putting a big bucket of water into a shark-infested pool. These animals turn from a nice, docile, beautiful snake to a snake that wham, grab hold of you, bites hold of you, and boy, do you know you've got a dangerous animal on your hands. Honestly, they're so majestic, they're gorgeous looking, but if you want to own one of these snakes, you're going to find out the hard way. No one likes getting bitten, you know, and sooner or later, you will get bit from a Burmese python or a reticulated python or an African rock python. You know, they're impressive, they're great looking. I rescued this animal from Saddleworth Moor. Now, the males on average will grow to about 18 feet long. Now, the females will on average will grow to about 23 foot long. The largest Burmese python ever recorded is 28 feet long, weighing close to 40 stone. Believe me, folks, you will not pick this animal up. You won't pick a 40 stone animal up. There's no way on earth. So if you're not picking it up, this animal will become wild. And you do not want a wild 20 odd foot Burmese python coming at you. There's no way on God's earth you'd want that. This is a granite Burmese python. I actually rescued him from Saddleworth Moor. There were two joggers who went out for a run, two boxers, and what they thought was jumping over a stick. They didn't jump over a stick, they was jumping over a snake. And he went wham, tried to grab hold of him, and things could have been very, very different that day. It just missed him by a coat of paint, unbelievable. He's beautiful though, absolutely majestic, what a gorgeous creature, but to be well respected. Absolutely. Have a look at it. Now, this is a blue-tongued skink, another one of my five-star rating animals. Blue-tongued skinks come from Australia. Now, these animals are actually evolving into snakes. Look at the size of them little tiny legs, and look at the vertebra, look at the backbone, look at the ribs. She's getting such a long body, really long, and look at that tail. Look at the tail, she can actually drop her tail. These animals are very docile, they're beautiful looking. Look at her, she looks like a T-Rex. Look at her beautiful face, absolutely incredible. These animals will eat birds, bats, frogs, toads. They'll actually eat little bits of chicken, you know, mealworms, lots of different insects. They can't move that fast. So mealworms is one of the favorite foods. It's said that they eat greens. I've got five of these animals and I've never seen one of them eat greens. I've seen them eat fruit, but I've never seen them eat lettuce or cabbage or anything like that. Aren't they stunning? Absolute beautiful. I wonder why they call them a blue tongue.